Wanted, dead or barely alive. Your old or outdated computers, monitors, and televisions, working or not. Don't trash it, recycle it. eCycle Washington makes it easy. Households, small businesses, public schools, and other organizations in Washington may drop off unwanted computers, monitors, and televisions at over 300 locations statewide for free. Find the location nearest you at eCycleWashington.org and click on Where Can I Recycle? That's eCycleWashington.org.
Hey, this is BJ. Thanks for listening to our show's podcast. If you're a fan of all things geeky, you should check out my other podcast, BJ Shea's Geek Nation. We have new episodes every day, and you can check it out at bjgeeknation.com.
Your wages are being garnished. We can stop that now. It's hard enough to pay your bills when things are good, let alone when a big chunk of your take-home pay is gone before you even get your check. I'm bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagné, and I can stop the garnishment and get the creditors off your back immediately, often the same day as our consultation. Both Chapter 7 and 13 provide bankruptcy relief, but choosing the right chapter is crucial. In a free consultation, we can create a plan to get your finances back under your control. The chapter you choose sets the tone for the next chapter of your life. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
99.9 KISW, the Rock of Seattle. If you don't got them, you got to get them. Your feet want them. The BJ and Migs rock socks.
See, Danny's rocking them today. Did you notice that?
Oh, look at that. Oh, they look
he's
sweet.
Got shorts on, and he's got them pulled all the way up.
Yeah.
My face is right under his kneecap.
Yes, it is. They look good, man.
That's right.
Oh, they look good.
It's
not
hot.
Too shabby.
My knees or the socks?
Both.
Okay,
yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah. You want your rock socks? You want to look awesome in short season? You got them. Go to KISW.com right now.
Let's play B Migs.
It's time to play the game.
Yeah.
So everybody scream his name. B Migs, don't be a loser.
Whoa.
B Migs, you're a loser.
It is time to B Migs, and it's time to pump it up for Monday.
And I don't know, man. Maybe Steve needs to pump it up.
I'm pumped.
You had a busy weekend, man.
I did.
Yeah, you wrestled
Friday.
I know.
Thrown into a bunch of chairs.
You got your ass kicked. But
I won. I mean, ass kicked. I won the match.
You got tossed into chairs, dude.
Did you see that, BJ?
Whoa.
It was
crazy.
Whoa, dude. Yeah.
Right?
Back body dropped into a sea of chairs.
I mean, congratulations on your win, but it was a long road to get there.
It was a long, arduous battle.
Wow. You won, though, huh?
That's right.
Wow. You took the law into your own hands.
Damn straight. I am the authority, BJ.
Wow.
Here's the law.
Big win at the end. It was a blast. Thanks to everyone who came out. I met a lot of really cool listeners on Friday night at Evolve Fitness for 3-2-1 battle. That was a blast.
Damn. Well, hopefully you can work your brain now because we got Beat Migs and we got Chris and Bellevue to take you on. Chris, are you there, sir?
I am.
Excellent. What's he playing for today?
Tickets to see Judas Priest.
Whoa.
They're going to be at the Showwear Center on June 21st. Go to KISW.com for all the details. You want to see Judas Priest? Get your tickets now. LiveNation.com.
All right, Steve.
I'm really excited about Judas Priest.
I know you were.
Yeah.
Get out of here. For those playing at home, Chris will have 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. Chris, you can pass all you want, but you will only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
I am.
Who was Leonardo DiCaprio's co-star in the 2002 movie Catch Me If You Can?
Tom Hanks.
Yes. What does the E stand for in email?
Internet?
No.
Electronic.
Yes. What decade was the beer Samuel Adams introduced?
1800s.
No.
1900s.
No.
2000?
No. What is the currency in Japan?
Yen.
Yes. Who played Jimmy in the 2001 movie Bubble Boy?
Pass.
How many quarters are in $50?
25.
No.
20.
No.
Oh, the math is killing me.
Pass.
What letter is between the B and the C on a standard computer keyboard?
B.
Yes. Oswald Cobblepot is better known as which Batman villain?
Penguin.
Yes! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 correct.
Ah, right down the middle.
I just left the, this math is killing me, and Vicky, pass it!
Yeah. You need a little help.
A little bit of help
hey,
there, got him.
It's still batting 500, which is better than the Mariners, so.
Yeah. Hey, yeah, exactly. Good point. Look on the positive side of life there, and maybe Steve got a, you know, drop kicked or pile drove in his
smacked
brain
around
a little out there.
The wrestling, man.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
He got smacked around a lot. He's got some aches and pains over here.
It's a brain physical sport. Functioning, I feel all right. Well, had an egg this morning, so I feel pretty good on National Egg Day.
They blow an egg on Egg Day, yeah.
They blow an egg. You can see that video somewhere.
Somewhere.
Yeah. I think it's on Pornhub.
Yeah.
Brazzers.
Oh. You should, never mind.
No.
With the Brazzers logo under that picture, Danny did a still shot of, yeah, of me trying to blow that egg.
Yeah, that's fantastic. That's yeah. People are paying good money to see that. Yeah.
Are you ready, Steve?
Oh, yeah.
Who was Leonardo DiCaprio's co-star in the 2002 movie Catch Me If You Can?
Tom Hanks.
Yes.
What movie?
What does the E stand for in email?
Electronic.
Yes. What decade was the beer Samuel Adams introduced?
What decade? Oh, man. I'm going to go to 50s.
No.
60s.
No.
40s.
No.
Oh.
No. What is the currency in Japan?
That would be money.
No.
Yen.
Yes. Who played Jimmy in the 2001 movie Bubble Boy?
Jimmy.
Jake Gyllenhaal. Yes. How many quarters are in $50?
69.
No.
100.
No.
50.
No.
Oh. Not even trying.
Yeah, I know. What letter is between the B and the C on a standard computer keyboard?
Crap. D?
No.
E?
No.
R?
No. Oswald Cobblepot is better known as which Batman villain?
The Penguin.
Yes. What U.S. state capital ends in the letter X?
Tex.
No.
Oh. S6.
No.
Close.
Actually, not the
Fox. No. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's a tie.
Wow. Good job,
you're
Chris.
Going to Judas Priest.
Yeah.
Nice. You hang on the line, but we'll tell you how to get your prize. Today was the random day I would have kicked Steve's butt.
Oh, you think so?
Yeah.
Twix?
Yeah.
Yeah, Twix is a state capital.
No. Why not?
A little southwest.
Yeah, I used to work there, Steve.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, San Francisco.
Yeah, that's it.
San Francisco.
Think of the desert.
Yeah.
Arizona.
Well, what's the capital of there?
What's a city in Arizona? Maybe a basketball
Tempe.
Team plays there named the Suns.
Phoenix.
There we go.
Thank you.
You're doing good.
Long road.
Maybe
right
I was concussed over the weekend.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I think he's concussed
perpetually.
Yeah.
Steve, now that you have the blindfold off, what is between the B and the C on a keyboard?
V.
Yeah.
V for vagina.
Whoa. All right.
For victory, BJ.
Oh, yeah, victory's a little bit better there. Yeah. Mm-hmm. How many quarters are in $50?
4 times 5 is 20, so say 200.
Yeah. Good job.
I'm so smart with my math. It's just, I mean, seriously, it's, I mean, honestly, it's 4 quarters on a buck.
Yeah. I mean, that's kind of what I was thinking
I mean,
with that
it's
one.
Not the most difficult to figure that out.
Well, it's Monday
when
morning.
When you're concussed from getting thrown into chairs, I can see.
It happens, BJ. It happens to the best of us.
It does. And then finally, what decade was the beer Samuel Adams introduced?
Yeah, it's a lot newer than you think.
Mm-hmm.
I would go 70s, 80s.
And 80s it is.
80s?
Yeah. 80s, yes.
It's Why do I have it in my head that it's just like this gold standard of old school beer?
Because Samuel Adams was an old guy.
That's why.
And that's why everyone just assumes.
Did he also make beer? Did he? I don't know if that's in his past or not.
No, I have no idea.
It's like himself. Like he just liked to make his own beer. I don't have
because
I don't know
idea.
Why they picked Sam Adams. It's a Boston-based company, but I don't know why Jim said, "Ah, we're gonna go with Sam Adams."
Maybe because he's from Boston.
I know, he told me the story, I'm sure, because we did broadcast there. I feel bad that I forget the origin, because I know we learned it.
In one ear, out the other. Just give me the beer.
I know.
It's a cool story, bro.
Sorry, Jim Cook. I mean, you always were great to us, and I just forget the whole reason why you called Sam Adams.
Well, congratulations to Chris on tying Steve and thus getting the prize.
There you go. You know what, call? That's all you gotta do. You tie or beat Steve, you get the prize, and like I said, Judas Priest tickets all week. All the week's pretty good.
According to Wikipedia, I'm just interested. He didn't brew beer, but he worked for his father's malt house, and they made malt that they sold to breweries.
There we go.
And that's how it's like kind of connected.
I knew there was a connection of the old school Sam Adams guy and why they called the beer Sam Adams.
All this time, I thought maybe Sam Adams had something to do with the beer. Like,
yeah.
Hey, I got a new beer idea.
Yeah.
Although, why would he be doing it in the 19? 19- 60s, like, I guess. I don't know.
Or actually the 80s, but yeah.
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 No, but as far as my guess, like, my logic still made no sense.
Well, yeah, you're right. Yeah. Yeah, I see what you say, because, yeah, right. Sammy Adams was like...
gone a lot longer.
Was he like the 1700s, one of the revolutionary guys, I think?
See, yeah, probably something like that.
See, on the Declaration of Independence? Or
you're pissing off so many smart people right now.
I can't remember, because, I mean, I don't even care about that stuff. I just happen to be from the Boston area, so I kind of know that he was a guy. I'm just assuming he was a revolutionary dude.
Yeah.
All right. Well, hey, got big news.
What happened?
It's official. We have a new Batman, Steve. And the rumors, they
Drew
were
Carey.
True. Yeah, it's not Drew Carey. Pattinson Man, or Pat's Man, whatever you want to call him. It's Robert Pattinson.
Oh, don't try that.
Yeah. Pat Man.
Team Edward Man. No? Okay. Yeah, Warner Brothers, they have confirmed that, in fact, Robert Pattinson, the boy from Twilight, is going to be in the upcoming movie, The Batman.
It's called The Batman?
Yes.
That's awesome.
Which is what he was called way back in the day, The Batman. It's not going to be another origin story. That's the good news. According to Matt Reeves, the director who stepped in after Ben Affleck said, "See it." He calls it a defining and very personal story about Batman.
Hmm.
And it's going to be coming out June of 2021, so we got a couple years.
Part of me is excited to see this because I know so many people are pissed off about it, so I want to support this movie just because of that. I don't care about Robert Pattinson, but I'm willing to give him a fair opportunity to be a great Batman.
Yeah,
I have issues with the guy because he chose to be in a hugely successful film franchise like Twilight. Not a film franchise I'm into. I know you love it, but I'm not a fan of it.
He's not even a fan of that franchise.
But no. He made a ton of money off of it. I don't begrudge the guy for that.
No, he's a British guy, just like, of course, Christian Bale was. So let's see if he can get the accent down. I haven't seen any of his... I haven't seen a lot of Robert Pattinson's work, so I don't know how well he does an American accent.
I don't know either, but I know he's been in a lot of dramatic type movies, and I think he's going to be a really good younger, dumber Bruce Wayne, because he's still kind of... I think the idea in this movie is that this is Batman getting his footing, just starting out being Batman.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. That's kind of what I was reading, what the director was doing, but I don't know if he can do Batman. I think Bruce Wayne he could do. I'm not sure if he could be Batman.
How did you feel? You see, and that's the thing.
A lot of people thought that was Michael Keaton. Remember, I thought he's a comedy actor. He can't do this, and then he became... arguably, for a lot of people, everyone's favorite Batman.
So I'm hoping to be pleasantly surprised.
Yeah, Michael Keaton is my favorite Batman of the Tim Burton era and all four of those Batman movies. But Christian Bale, to me, is my favorite movie Batman. So those are the shoes he has to fill, is he's got to fill the Christian Bale shoes, and that's tough. Just like when we see this Joker movie, we'll see how Joaquin Phoenix does, because it's tough. All I think of is Heath Ledger as a defining Joker.
And no one can compare to Lego Batman.
Oh, yeah, Lego Batman.
Is Will Arnett is amazing.
I almost wanted Will Arnett to be the guy because he does. He's got
a strong chin for the cowl. I think he'd be fine.
It's just, you could. All you would think of is the Lego movies. That's the problem. if you knew it was Will Arnett,
that's
just
not
knew.
So bad.
Yeah.
I love someone on a news story that Deadline put up there, and someone put, "This is hysterical. Walt Warner's is elderly and out of touch. Was Justin Bieber unavailable? Ha ha."
That would have been epic troll.
No, Justin Bieber is Robin.
There you go.
There you go.
And Machine Gun Kelly is the Joker.
Sure, why not?
Yes.
Well, you know,
just piss off every older person that likes Batman.
And I just, all I can think of Robert Pattinson is there is a brooding nature to Batman. So I think that he does have a look of a guy who's, you know, just like, he's handsome, he's rich, but there's something about him that just is off. And Robert Pattinson does give that sort of vibe. So I think maybe he'll be a good Batman. I think he'll be a good Bruce Wayne. And I mean, look, with CGI and everything, how can you not be a good Batman as long as you train up and you kick people, right?
And one person says the people crapping all over Robert Pattinson being Batman are basing off of movies that he did 10 years ago and haven't seen some of the more recent stuff like Maps to the Stars or The Rover. He's actually a pretty good actor.
And that doesn't surprise me, because he's born in England, and pretty much if you're an English actor, I think you get Shakespearean training, and it's no surprise that a lot of our successful shows and movies have English actors, which a lot of people don't know, because they really get trained well. I mean, so I'm with that texture. Let's see what he does.
And a few people brought up a good point. How many people thought it was a good idea when they first cast Heath Ledger as the Joker?
Yeah, I don't remember if there was this much of an outcry.
Well, we didn't have social media the way we have now.
Yeah, you're right.
You know what I mean? Well, we might have had. Yeah. Barely.
Not
nobody was using social media just to bitch all the time.
You're right.
Like they do now.
It was more or less to show off all your cool stickers and stuff on MySpace.
And tell you what song you're listening to.
Exactly.
I remember everybody hated Anne Hathaway's choice to be Catwoman, and I actually liked her Catwoman a lot.
Yeah, no Halle Berry, but yeah. I mean, she was good.
Steve!
Okay, you stop.
And I'm done with that conversation. Hey, a couple of deep-sea fishermen found a secret to catching a lot of fish. You know what it is? Cocaine. Yeah, you're going to find out what I'm talking about. I'll tell you all about it at 717 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. A couple of deep-sea fishermen in South Carolina caught more than just fish over the weekend as they reeled in $1 million in cocaine. Wow.
I'm in love with the coco.
Man. Yeah. Wow. Apparently, they noticed that the fish just kept jumping out of the water and tipping off the fishermen yesterday afternoon. And every time they passed the area where the debris was, they would catch a fish. So after about 3 hours of fishing, they decided to see why all the fish were bugging out. And
wait, so were the fish high on coke?
Yeah, they
quite
were.
Possibly.
They were jacked up, just jumping around.
One Texas says, cocaine used for fishing. What are they catching? Blowfish?
Hey,
nice.
Nice. Yeah. And they caught Hootie. I don't know if they caught the blowfish, though.
Oh, geez. Yeah. I just left it with the text guys.
It's all right. Same, geez, man, you know. Just, you know, try to have fun with people. So, yeah, 3 hours of fishermen, they were like, okay, what's going on? We got to figure this out. They reeled in this very strange object covered in black plastic, and, yep, they found out it was bricks and bricks of coke.
Wow.
Ended up pulling in about 30 to 50 kilos.
Wait, like I said, 30 to 50, so how many did they keep?
Yeah, that's the thing. We don't know how 30 to 50. We're not sure.
We lost 20 of them. We're not sure where they went.
They called the Coast Guard. Coast Guard came, said, yep. This cocaine right here, street value between $750,000 and $1 million. Again, depending on how 30 to 50, we'll see how much they kept.
Wow. I wish they had video of these fish and what they were doing.
Yeah, I would love to see them just bouncing around.
I'm really picturing them all hopped up on coke, kind of losing their minds.
They really were flying fish, man. They were just so easy to catch. That's the kind of fishing trip I want to go on.
And I can't imagine you can eat the fish afterwards without maybe getting some sort of side effect.
Nothing wrong with that.
So coke-infused salmon.
Yeah, that's the new dish.
Mm.
Yeah,
Coming soon. To your local sushi joint.
Yeah.
It's the lukewarm topic of the day.
So a couple of deep-sea fishermen reeled in about $1 million worth of cocaine that they found in the water. So based on this, we want you to finish this sentence. I can't believe I found blank. 206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999. Finish this sentence. I can't believe I found blank.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9
KISW, The Rock of Seattle. A couple of deep sea fishermen reeled in about $1 million worth of cocaine that they found in the water. Based on this, we want you to finish this sentence. I can't believe I found blank. 206-421-ROCK, text us at 77999. Let's go to Jeff in Seattle. Jeff, you are on The Rock.
All right.
What's up, buddy? Morning. What you got for us today?
I found a brick of marijuana in the tailgate of a minivan.
Nice.
Ooh, there we go. Now, how did you have access to this minivan?
I was working as a body man. We were replacing the tailgate on the vehicle, and I was cutting it open to get the styrofoam crush stuff out of it to transfer over to the new one, and pulled out a cellophane-wrapped brick of marijuana.
Nice. So what'd you do with it? you smoked it.
Well, yeah. we checked it out, and it had been in there so long, it was just dry, almost dust.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Still pack it up and smoke it, see what happens.
Well, it may have been. The minivan used to be a rental car, and an older couple had bought it, and got rear-ended. We were replacing the tailgate and found it in there. So I'm guessing in its life as a rental van, it was used for whatever purposes.
And so the old people had no idea when they bought it that they had themselves a nice little package in there.
I would assume no.
Wow. Well, it's like that time when we were in Chicago and we're just walking around the streets outside of the Wrigley Field and we're waiting across the street and a bag of pot just flies out of the air and lands in front of us.
That was so bizarre.
That was incredible.
It just floated on by like a Disney movie something.
Yeah, like Ganja, the Greek god of pot.
I remember you guys
hand this over to us.
I remember you guys were clamoring for that. I didn't know what the hell you were, because I didn't know what it was. I'm an ignorant idiot. And you guys were like, holy cow, is that
surprise? A bag of weed just flew out from the sky. So then you realize, it must have came out. Someone must have threw it out of the bus that just went right by us.
Nice.
And there it was for us to have.
Congratulations.
Stare at and do nothing with.
Well, because wasn't there a cop nearby?
Yeah, we did take... because soon after that, we took pictures with those cops.
Oh.
Remember?
Yeah.
That was when Nick was with us, and he had it
in his pocket.
Yeah. And you can see in the picture, he's got this look like, please don't smell us. Please don't smell us.
Yeah.
Oh,
that's
God.
Awesome. I haven't found anything really awesome, but my mother-in-law down on 3rd Avenue a couple of years ago literally found a $12,000 diamond earring.
Whoa.
It was in just the gutter. She saw a sparkle off the sunlight, was like, oh, I wonder if that's real. Picked it up, got it appraised. It was, and so she fashioned it into a ring. And now she's got a big, fat bling ring.
Oh, so she just kept it.
Oh, yeah.
$12,000 diamond ring, and she's like, I'm keeping this bad boy.
Oh, of course, yeah. I would too.
If it's in the gutter,
And it was in the gutter. I mean, there was like nobody around to like, it was like, oh, that's my ring, or no one was looking for one at that point.
Yeah, because women lose earrings all the time. That's a beating.
This looked like a sports ball. I'm sorry, a sports player. Like their big fat bling rings, like the earrings that they'd wear, something like that. Yeah, it was cool.
Wow.
Along those same lines, Lily found a wedding engagement ring combination at the zoo when I was there.
Your daughter found a wedding ring at the zoo?
Yeah. We were walking around, and it was by the monkey cages, and she just looks down, and she's like, Dad, look, what's this? It's a ring. And I picked it up, and it was legit, like, gold. And
was it true that the monkey found out that the other monkey had an affair, and they wanted a divorce, and threw the ring?
Threw it out of this,
Yeah. Which means the poop was following. You better pick up the ring and run, because you know the monkeys, when they're mad, they throw everything.
Yeah.
So do with the ring?
We turned it into Lost and Found.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, at that point, I figured it's a family place, and I wanted to make a good impression on Lily.
Oh, good.
If I was by myself, I would have probably kept it.
That's right.
John's pawn shop.
Yeah.
I love, because Danny's always said, if he ever found anything or any...
He's keeping it.
He's keeping it. People are stupid if they lose stuff, but there he is with his daughter, and he's going to be like...
So you just taught your daughter to be a chump and turn it in.
Yeah.
Good job.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Yeah, I thought you had values and you were going to teach her the Danny way.
Well, you know.
I guess you know your way is wrong. Now we can really make you feel bad every time you'll steal something from somebody.
Yeah, I don't want to get yelled at by my ex and teaching her wrong. And so I was like, all right. Because she's going to tell everyone.
Yeah.
So
it's not worth it. No, that was a way smarter decision. You can't put a price on being bitched out by your ex.
Right.
Yeah, I forgot about that. Yeah, that's a good point, Steve.
What if, though, that was something that I joke about the monkeys, but what if there's a couple that had a big fight and the woman's just like, screw you in this marriage, and took the ring off and threw it.
Is that, you mean, is it up for grabs?
I feel like at that point,
right? Just keep it.
I'd be a bad devil on your shoulder. You're probably getting divorced. Just sell it.
This is what happened, yeah.
Yeah, so that's the wedding ring. What if she threw the engagement ring? Do you think it's the property of the groom or the groom-to-be? See, the wedding ring, you're saying, Steve, it's ours if we find it.
Right.
But if she did that to an engagement ring and said...
Well, we don't know the context. What if, like, he had an affair?
Ooh.
At that point, does he deserve the ring back?
Jeez.
With one of the monkeys.
Right.
Yeah. Had an affair with one of the monkeys. Okay, that guy's got some serious problems. He's not going to have any... Where he's going, he's not going to need any money.
His name's Mark Wahlberg.
Yeah.
He's doing research for his film.
What? Of all the worst of the reboot Planet of the Apes movies, you bring that one up.
Mm. Which one am I supposed to bring up?
Well, I don't know.
Charlton Heston, maybe?
Yeah.
Dude.
They don't know. Nobody. He's right, Rev. Nobody knows Charlton Heston.
Come on, really? Yeah.
Well, James Franco was in a good Planet of the Apes. Like the one he was in was a good movie.
I feel like more people remember Mark Wahlberg being in a Planet of the Apes than Charlton Heston these days.
All right.
Yeah, but I keep thinking Mark Wahlberg in Transformers, so I totally forgot he was in Planet of the Apes.
You know why?
He's in a lot of good movies.
Ha ha ha!
Well, that would stop the room.
Yeah, jeez, I can't even say anything.
Boogie Nights?
Well, yeah, I'm not saying that Mark Wahlberg's not in a lot of good movies. I'm saying Planet of the Apes is not one of the good movies he's been in.
Oh, I wouldn't disagree with you on that.
Okay,
one.
Yeah. I'm not disparaging Mark Wahlberg. I'm disparaging that movie.
How about somebody said I found a bag of crack at the 7-Eleven one time? Woo! I sold it for $200.
Damn!
I'd be too scared to try and resell that.
Yeah, right?
Oh, I don't
even know what crack really looks like, to be honest with you.
Oh. It's whack. That's all I know.
I know it's rock form, right?
Yeah, basically.
Well, I mean, if you don't know what it looks, let's sell Steve some crack. He doesn't know what it looks like.
But I'm not looking to buy crack, BJ.
Dude, it kind of looks like Parmesan cheese.
Does
it? The fresh kind, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah, kind of does.
A little yellowy,
I want some Parmesan cheese now.
Yeah, but you don't want crack.
All right, I'm going to get some Parmesan cheese. Well, I'm going to sell it to Steve for a cheap price so you can resell it for a higher price.
Oh, it's like the oregano trick.
Yeah.
Or give me the crack and I can just kind of grind it up and then spread it on top of my pasta or my pizza.
Oh, that won't be a bad idea.
Yeah, that will work.
Yeah, that's a great idea. So he says, I once found a used condom under the blanket at a hotel.
Oh.
Port Orchard.
Dude, I found
it. Give me a new room. Give me a new room.
Yeah.
I found one in a dressing room at a department store. I went in to, like, try on a bunch of clothes, and I'm like, oh, I'm not using any of these now.
No.
I'm like, I don't want any clothes right now.
Yeah.
Texter says, I can't believe I found my best friend plowing my now ex-wife. Hashtag whore.
Awkward.
Whoa. Yeah, that's a can't believe I found. God. I don't want to walk in on it. I really don't. I mean, I'd rather have somebody come and tell me they're having an affair than to walk in on it.
Especially if it's somebody you know.
Yeah.
I mean, that just ends two relationships.
Well, don't you ask? Would you ask, Steve?
What?
If you found out that a woman that you cared about was having an affair, would you ask her who was it with? Because I would.
Mm.
See, that's the problem. Even if I don't walk in on the person, I still am going to want to know who it was. I feel like that's just me.
I feel like my knee-jerk reaction would be, with who?
Exactly.
So, yeah.
See, that's the problem. So, walking in or not, you're going to find out. Oh, that was, yeah. Oh, damn.
Somebody says, a year ago in Alaska, I got into a cab around 6 in the morning, headed to work, and the seat next to me was a pint of R&R and a $100 bill. I couldn't help to think I was on Dateline's What Would You Do? So, I told the cab driver. I'm pretty sure he kept both.
Yeah,
I remember that show, What Would You Do?
Yeah, that's the problem. I don't know if I would tell the cab driver. You know they're not going to turn it in.
You don't think?
No.
Well, like this guy, he's like, what if I'm being secretly recorded for a show and then they're going to air it and they're going to see what I did?
Well, do they get to air you without telling you in those kind of shows?
No, I feel like they have to at some point come up to you and say, hey, we filmed that.
Yeah,
and then you get permission.
How much money can they pay you to do it?
Double it.
Yeah. Just $200 and you let them air you stealing money out of a cab?
Sure.
Well, Steve, you're an easy. You know what?
I feel like if I ask more, they're gonna be like, "Nah, screw it, not worth it."
But then you get your $100 without nobody knowing that you're a thief.
I'd rather have $200 with people knowing I'm a thief as opposed to $100 right. No one knows.
See, I want to live your life. You don't care what people think about you, and you're a richer man for it.
Somebody said my girlfriend once walked up to an ATM, found $200 cash just sitting there. Score. Some sucker withdrew it and forgot it.
Oh.
How do you forget to grab the money you just withdrew?
I've forgotten my card before, but not the cash.
Yeah, I know, because you lay stuff down. I have done that before because you lay stuff down that's why I never lay any money down anywhere, because I know I'm going to forget
it. Oh, you have left it?
Well, I've left stuff before, not money, but I've left like a wallet somewhere, I've left my keys somewhere because I've laid them down and then go, oh, what the hell? So, like, I don't lay money down anywhere.
All right, what were we doing this one? Someone said that they found a $100 bill in a pair of shoes. I bought it for 99 cents at the thrift store. You keep the money or do you go back to the thrift store?
No.
That's yours, right?
Keep the money. Somebody donated those shoes and they're never going to know who they had them or who had them.
So, so people hide their money in their shoes? Like, that's a thing you do in the house?
That's not something I do.
Because I feel like,
feet being the same way where my money
people
is.
Just stash money in strange places.
Yeah, because when people pass away and all of a sudden you're cleaning out folks' stuff, I know that whenever I have that job, I check everything because that's what you hear. You hear they stash money in the weirdest places. So I don't just, like, throw every bit of clothing. It takes me a long time. But why are you taking so long to pack up those clothes? I'm checking every pocket, buddy.
Where do you stash your money that you have at home?
Yeah.
Up to
I'm not going to make any money.
I was just curious.
Up my prison wallet is what you're saying?
Yes.
Well, it has wallet in the name.
Well, then at that point, it's not where I stash it at home because I go everywhere, Steve.
Oh, okay.
So right now, you should ask me, where do I stash it at work? Then I can tell you the prison wallet.
Oh, my.
Yeah. And Vicky, no, you're going to have to work for it. Go on a scavenger hunt. I'm not just going to tell you where everything is
now. It's like an Easter egg hunt for BJ's money.
Yeah.
I'm down.
Yeah, me too.
Try one of your board games.
Oh, yeah. The Monopoly money is real.
That would be cool. That would be cool if I just pulled out Monopoly and all of a sudden you're going...
That's actually real money.
That's a brilliant place to put it because you'll remember which board game did I put it in. Of course, you got to do one that's cash based.
Of course,
and it's the game that nobody wants to play.
Exactly.
Yeah.
True.
Oh yeah. That's it. So where do you think I put all my murder weapons?
Clue.
Exactly. There you go.
I love this. This is great.
See, nobody would ever think of looking at it. So if you ever murder anybody, make sure you put all your murder weapons in Clue.
You keep all of your hippos in the hungry, hungry hippo box, right?
Yeah,
sure. Or maybe food.
Nice. Yeah, that's exactly where I keep them, Steve.
And all your cheese and mousetrap.
Yes.
Yes. There we go.
God, I love that game.
We are really seeing who actually plays board games on this show and the guys that haven't played board games since they were kids.
Yeah, I'm tracking with Danny. Mousetrap was a fantastic game.
Yep.
Yeah.
Fun for all ages. 3 to 83.
Very true. I still play that game.
I don't know if I can talk to you guys anymore.
You should bust that out one time just to kind of get the reaction of your board game friends.
Straight faced.
Come out with Chutes and Ladders. Like, guys, I found this new game.
I would laugh at you, but they did a reskin of a game very similar to that called Fireball Island, and it was a big hit last year.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody wanted it. And I remember looking at it going, guys, I remember this game. It's like Mousetrap. I don't care about this stupid game, but everybody loved it.
But it has a volcano with boulders.
Exactly.
They crash into stuff.
Yeah.
Ooh, somebody said they dropped a friend off at the airport, found $400 on the curb. I waited 10 minutes. Nobody showed up. I split it with my friend.
There you go. Oh, even split it. Nice.
$400 on the curb. So somebody dropped a couple of hundies out of the wallet. That's what happened. Wow. Yeah. That probably happened when they were like probably going to tip someone for their luggage, maybe.
$400?
Well, they might have pulled out the stack to give them.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Dude, what happens when you figure out, like, maybe you're going to Vegas? And like that's your cash that you're using. You're all pumped, and you get to Vegas, and you check your pocket. And you're like, where is my money?
Yeah, dude. Oh, that's bad. Oh, that's unfortunate. We got a high school principal just got busted for plagiarizing his graduation speech.
This is the greatest audio ever.
And he stole it from Ashton Kutcher.
That's what makes it the greatest audio ever.
Yeah, you're going to hear that audio at 7:47 on The Rock.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. He's here right now and has agreed to answer more of your questions about bankruptcy. Here's another listener question. How do I rebuild my credit after filing bankruptcy?
You rebuild it, you know, one creditor at a time by making your payments on time on your rent or your mortgage, by continuing to make car payments on a car that you keep during your case. You can also, as I said, you can almost always get a credit card almost immediately after filing bankruptcy. Sometimes it's a secured card and it'll almost always have a really high interest rate on it, but you can get a small balance credit card and, you know, charge a tank of gas or a dinner once a month on that and make the payment, pay it off every month, and that'll help you build a credit history one creditor at a time and will help you rebuild your credit over time.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at choosetherightchapter.com. That's choosetherightchapter.com. Thanks for listening.
Wait. Don't trash that used or broken computer, monitor, or TV. Do the right thing. Recycle your unwanted or non-working electronics for free. You can recycle computers, monitors, and televisions with eCycle Washington. Households, small businesses, public schools, and other organizations may drop off unwanted TVs, computers, and monitors at over 300 locations in Washington State for free. Find the location nearest you at eCycleWashington.org and click on Where Can I Recycle? That's eCycleWashington.org.